my name is Khairul Wan. I'm 30 years old this year and I'm a renovation contractor. During secondary school, masih okay. Still macam, you know, I attended sekolah secondary, tak pernah cabut sekolah, semua clean record. Adalah nakal-nakal sikit, gaduh here and there. So, bila dah keluar secondary school, bila time masuk ITE, tu yang macam ada sikit go wild lah. Macam campur sana, campur sini, habis kononnya nak tunjuk belang lah, something like that lah. Macam at that age nak prove something lah, you know, that you are part of, to fit in lah at that time lah. So, lepas keluar daripada secondary, masuk ITE, basically time ITE kita tak ada, we don't know what we want. Kita tak tahu kita nak masuk electrical engineering ke, kita nak masuk designer ke, haircut ke. So we just go with the flow. Apa yang dapat kita just ambil. At that point tak ada macam sense of direction lah. Jadi apa datang kat kita, kita accept aja. Macam kawan, first thing is company, apa datang kat kita, kita accept. The courses, education datang kat kita, kita pun tak tahu apa kita nak, so kita main accept. Kita minat tak minat pun kita tak tahu at that time. So then that's where started off macam dia punya lack of macam direction lah, where we want. Habis kita main ikut aja. At that time also kurang nasib for me that I chose a few company yang kurang, bukan cakap kurang baik lah, tapi they have some sort of macam nakal-nakal sikit lah. Macam dulu sekolah kita gaduh, kita jual benda illegal. Just to occupy kita punya time kat sana. Because sekolah pun kita tak ikut sangat education. So we go there just to meet friends, have fun, dah. Lepas tu balik, dah, that's it. But tattoo ni kan, Actually dulu time kecil-kecil, kalau kau kasi aku whiteboard ke, kau kasi aku paper putih pun, aku still doodle around, draw. Because kecil-kecil kita punya creativity memang up there lah. So of course during that time, kita mix around dengan orang yang penuh dengan art dekat badan lah. So we find it macam style lah. I didn't see it macam in the term fierce, tapi macam self expression lah. Yeah, so I design my own, lepas tu letak pap. Then balik, mak tengok, nangis lah.
Macam mana kau punya reaction lepas mak nangis?
dia nangis. Parents semua macam shock lah, you know, typical Melayu punya family. When they see this, straight away they think, alamak, kau budak jahat lah, kau campur ni, you gonna have a wild path ahead lah. But in the back of my mind, I know that benda ni is something that I choose for what I want. And this is my sort of macam the things that I choose lah at that time lah, what my perception is lah. For me personally, kalau aku nampak budak Angkong Xiao jalan tepi road pun, aku tengok, I mean, this guy is the same as all of us. You know, it's just whether kita nak stereotype, kita nak duduk berbual dengan dia. Mana tahu dia pun, dia businessman ke, dia sedekah sana sini pun, bukan semestinya dia jahat ke apa kan.
Kau pernah jumpa tak orang-orang yang ada tu, tapi lebih baik daripada orang yang ada
tu? Oh, pernah. Banyak lah. In fact, a few friends yang aku kenal yang ada tattoo, ada yang they are doing something in life lah. Doing something as in they are rendering dia orang punya services, entrepreneurs. Even how to say, this kind of people they are more open lah. Diorang tak stereotype people. They don't look into one type of human being. They are open. Diorang, I would say, more artistic. Some of them, they are more daring, more bold. So if you ask me, kalau pernah nampak orang yang baik bila ada tattoo, of course lah. Pernah, even my a few friends sampai ke sini semua, tapi semayang tak tinggal, sedekah. And rezeki orang pun murah pasal diorang sedekah banyak. Yang dah sampai ke sana atau yang belum, kita semua pandai. Kita semua ada that creativity level, ada that determination nak bikin. Whether kita nak ke tanah lah, that's a big question lah. They are good and bad lah. So macam this COVID thing, circuit breaker pun ada some opportunities I see lah dalam this adversity to all of us lah. Macam to me, I take this 2 months duduk kat rumah, you know, in fact macam really reflect back on what I've been doing for the past maybe 25 years. Kerjakan harta, kerjakan dunia, kerjakan everything yang kita boleh achieve lah dengan kaki tangan kita. So after this 2 months dekat rumah, kerja kena stop. So tak ada gaji lah, bergerak tapi tak banyak. So but I realise walaupun kita ada medium amount of whatever income we have, kita still boleh macam survive. I mean goes back to what we want lah. Macam perbelanjaan kita, whether pada kita satu nasi dengan ayam telur cukup, atau nak nasi, nak ayam besar, kereta, nak kereta Toyota cukup, nak kereta Volkswagen, nak kereta Mercedes. So it's up to us macam mana kita manage lah, manage kita punya expectation. Kalau kita nak orang pandang kita gini, kita nak adakan certain things in life, in life. So kita nak kena keep up to that standard, which is penat lah. I would say macam sebenarnya apa tujuan kita dekat dunia ni, whether kita nak barang things or we want to have experience to help people ke apa. So that 2 months punya period I was thinking macam okay, I will take this opportunity macam mana nak really macam masukkan diri dalam gua, isolate myself from whatever things that we are doing. So I delete my social media, my Facebook, to prevent myself to tengok apa yang ada current trend semua lah. So when I did that, I found something in myself lah. Macam actually kita human we only need what we basically need aja. We don't need that much lah. What we've been doing all this while before circuit breaker, before my recall feedback apa yang kita buat all this past year lah, is that kita kerjakan dunia sangat lah. Which is too much things in life. At the end of the day, yang penting kita ada shelter, kita ada transport yang biasa-biasa dah cukup. Kita makan minum dah cukup. Family orang kita sayang, members yang kita boleh trust, ni semua cukup. So this circuit breaker really did something on me lah. Dia macam make me think back about what is our actual purpose in life lah, to me lah. Bila time aku dulu nak OAD daripada NS kan. So biasa lah budak-budak macam kita dulu OAD tak tahu nak buat apa, what to do after OAD lah, semua macam blank lah. So for me I was a bit lucky lah, because a friend of mine approach me, cakap abang ipar dia ada BCA punya some internship lah, buat macam on job training lah. So tak fikir apa-apa, I just decide to join. Bila join, lepas tu I still remember there's this guy lah, one of the hiring manager, dia cakap, oh if you continue in this line, one day you will reach there, you can earn up to 5 to 6K. So to me, I take it as a motivation lah. Gaji macam itu, dulu dengar gaji tinggi macam itu macam wow, okay, suit je lah. Then masuk all the way lah, masuk dulu macam teruk lah, makan kat bawah longkang. Kan, orang tengok pun, wah budak ni, budak Singapura ni cuci longkang lah apa. Ada malu juga lah, but at that time pun I tak ceriwit kan, bukannya ada pelajaran ke apa. So start from below lah, buat kerja-kerja macam kerja-kerja tai kan. So along the way, bila kita niat kita baik, niat kita nak tolong orang, nak render service to people lah, dia punya rezeki dia datang lah. Rezeki dia datang, and then lagi kita banyak tolong orang, rezeki dia pun makin datang. Janji kita tak macam selfish lah, ada kepercayaan pada Tuhan dia. All the way kita sabar, kita niat kita baik. Of course ada ups and downs, hilang kawan, gain trust, lost trust, kerja tak happy, ini semua biasa lah. Jumpa bos tak girik, jumpa bos girik, jumpa klien yang ada-gada, jumpa klien yang boleh sikit lebih kurang, ini semua All these things I've been through. Kadang-kadang pernah like last year duduk dalam kereta sorang-sorang sampai aku nangis, because the things that I do is too difficult lah. Because I thought wow, boleh straight away kat company ni run, and I realise macam wow, it is not that easy lah, but it is doable lah, whether kita punya niat yang kita percaya pada Tuhan aja. So from there, The things yang happen to us, yang benda obstacle semua, kita one thing aja, kita percaya pada Tuhan, kita niat kita baik, kita nak bersedekah, kita punya kaki tangan. Bersedekah tak semestinya sedekah duit, kita sedekah kita punya diri. pergi rumah orang tolong repair aircon, pergi rumah orang pipe choke ke apa, tangan letak je dalam tai tarik. Ni semua kita punya charity tu untuk the community lah. So pelan-pelan buat macam gini, then setelah pelan-pelan rezeki datang. Since aku dah I would say dah have certain resources lah, macam maybe in terms of capital, in terms of contacts, in terms of jobs that I have, aku dapat tolong members juga. Then ada juga macam members aku yang baru keluar, masih isap dada semua. So aku forcefully panggil orang kerja dengan aku untuk give them some things to do in life lah. Macam at least orang tak, you know, yeah, to the point aku terpaksa potong gaji aku just to ensure diorang aku dapat bayar diorang lah. So at least, you know, give them something to do lah. Dari, because diorang, I wouldn't want to criticize them, tapi it's just that they lack of some sense of direction. So kalau kita dapat, kita yang ada certain resources, why not we help all these people? Ni semua brother-brothers kita juga, kawan kita semua. Kenapa kita nak pandang rendah kat diorang? At the end of the day, kita mati pun kita tinggalkan barang-barang dunia semua kat sini juga. Itu je. So for orang yang belum ada arah atau hilang arah along the way, naik apa, lost, lepas tu kembali, lepas tu lost, lepas tu kembali. So first thing important is your environment dengan orang yang kita campur. Second thing is the mentor that you mix with, okay? The mentor that you take into your life. Mentor is very important. To me, I got a lot of mentor. So mentor very important. Environment, mentor. Number 3 is jangan cerewet. Starting kerja kena buat saikang lah, kena kat tai ke apa, bikin aja. Jangan kita ada orang masuk nak terus nak that level, no. Okay. Number 3, jangan cerewet. Apa tak kasih, bikin je. Bikin dengan ikhlas. Number 4, kita punya mindset nak kena kuat, jangan give up. Dan jangan dengar orang luar cakap apa kan. Because kalau kita tengah nak develop diri kita, orang-orang luar akan cakap ni, cakap tu. So kita nak kena focus on the goal aja. Apa yang korang dengar, maybe good for you, maybe not. So kalau yang tak, masuk kiri keluar kanan je. Kalau yang korang nak take into this kind of advice, then good for you lah. Because ni pun ada, is a real life experience for me also lah. Okay, thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and share and subscribe.